Well, thanks, John. You know, I love when I get to hang out with adorable pets on a Friday. We have some adorable kittens and a dog joining me, and they are from Pound Pets, which is a rescue in Granite City. Also joining me, Kathy and Barry. Kathy, first tell me a little bit about Pound Pets. You guys are a small rescue, but you're taking in a lot of animals.
We are. We're a small rescue. Our building is actually set up to hold about 24 cats, 7 large dogs, 4 large dogs. We are full, and we have 70 cats in our facility.
You're set to hold 24. You just told me you had 70.
Exactly. And we have more than 12 dogs, too. Our foster homes are all full also.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
So it takes a lot of work. These pets need a lot of care. They need food, water, shelter, obviously,
and
then medical bills. And Belle is a prime example of an animal that needs some medical treatment.
Yes.
Barry, you really took Belle, and you just showed me a picture of her. How much did she weigh when you found her?
36 pounds.
And that was how long ago?
6 weeks.
You showed me a picture. You could see her, all of her ribs, all of them.
Yeah. She almost died. She was that starved, and took 4 days in the hospital, and then 6 weeks at home of round-the-clock feedings. And now she's 65 pounds.
She's
and just about to her normal weight.
She is so well-mannered, too.
Thank you. Thank you. She's a really good dog. We were fostering, and we've ended up adopting her now.
So where do these pets come from? I mean, do you guys find them on the streets? Do you take them in when people can't no longer take them?
Yes.
Yeah, I work for Animal Emergency Center in Collinsville, and Belle was actually brought into our facility, and that's how I met Deb.
All of our animals come in as strays from Granite City.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. So we are looking for homes for all of these. We're looking for adopters as much as we're looking for funds for medical bills. We just really need to move some cats and some dogs.
You guys are actually in the process of fundraising right now.
Exactly.
Two upcoming events. One is on Sunday?
Yes, Sunday. On Sunday and again on Wednesday, it is a haunted house. It's Hotel Evil.
Mm-hmm.
And Jim and Sue turn their house over and make it a haunted house. And we've decorated that for weeks, and it's beautiful. It's a dark side of Disney.
Okay.
It's kid-friendly, so it's not scary.
So not super haunted.
Not super haunted, no. And fun events for the kids, so bring out the family. I mean, it's on donations. It's free, but we ask for donations.
Right.
And the donations benefit us and the Metro East Community Rotary.
So, like you said, it's free, but it's donation-based.
Exactly,
Please come out if you do come out and donate a little bit. And that again, is Sunday, and what time?
It starts at 5:30 and it runs till 9.
Okay.
And it's on Sunday, and then we'll have an open house again on the 30th. Wednesday the 30th.
Wednesday the 30th. Two chances to come out to the Dark Side of Disney haunted house. Again, not too haunted, because we're talking about kittens and pets, and those are cute. So I feel like you guys know your audience here.
Yes.
And you will have a second fundraiser as well.
Yes.
Tell me about that one.
This is our big fundraiser. It's a dueling pianos fundraiser.
I love dueling pianos.
Yes, yes, yes. Spanky Entertainment's going to come out for us. It's going to be at the Collinsville Fireman's Hall. Tickets are $30, but it includes a full dinner and a show, and of course we'll have adoptables on hand. 50-50 drawing, raffles, silent auction, lots of fun. Yeah.
I know we're doubling up on the fundraiser here, but you guys have basically doubled up on animals, so I feel like it's necessary. It makes sense.
As being small, we are donation-based.
Right?
We've had $69,000 in medical bills to date this year.
Thank you guys so much for coming, and thank you for all you do for these pets. Belle, I am so happy that you look fantastic this morning, and you are a healthy, beautiful dog. All right, stick with us, though. We still have more ahead on the 9 a.m.